lies with its client. For now, we're live in Greenpoint, Brooklyn. Kimberly Richardson, Channel 7, Eyewitness News.
Okay. Thanks, Kimberly. Still ahead, a deadly hit and run. A mystery. Who did this? Eyewitness News at 6 starts now.
This is New York's number one news. Channel 7 Eyewitness News. With Bill Ritter and Liz Cho. Rob Powers with sports. And Lee Goldberg with the exclusive AccuWeather forecast. Now, Eyewitness News at 6.
Chief trying to unite his party. First meeting with Bernie Sanders and then endorsing Hillary Clinton. And now the nation's first black president will hit the road, making the case for a woman to be the next president. But first,
I understand this is politics. Well, it's my turn in the battle.
The ousted president of the New York City Correction Officers Union talking exclusively tonight to Eyewitness News, one day after he was charged with corruption and taking kickbacks. Good evening, everyone. At 6 o'clock, I'm Bill Ritter. Liz is off tonight. He was, until today, one of the most powerful union presidents in all of New York. A $300,000 a year salary for a job advocating for one of the most dangerous occupations there is. A correction officer at Rikers Island Jail. Norman Seabrook, accused of taking huge amounts of money to funnel union pensions into one particular hedge fund. Tonight, he's proclaiming his innocence. Eyewitness News anchor David Navarro with our exclusive lead story. David.
Bill, for 21 years, Norman Seabrook has been the head of the Correction Officers Benevolent Association, but now a scandal has tainted his legacy. Today, for the first time since he was charged with bilking his members of more than $20 million out of their own money, Seabrook is talking exclusively to Eyewitness News. Norman Seabrook arrived at his Bronx